everybody. Today, I'm going to show you how to close your Google form both manually and automatically. Closing your form stops people from answering it. For any time-based form, like a job application or a raffle giveaway, it's a pretty essential feature. Unfortunately, there's no built-in way to have your Google form closed on a certain date or when you hit a max number of submissions. You can close your forms manually, but if you want it done automatically, you'll need to use an add-on. Let's go over how to do it both ways. The first option, closing your form manually, is actually pretty easy. Just jump into the form you want closed, click on the Responses tab, and toggle on Not Accepting Responses. This will turn off your form right away, blocking anyone else from answering it. It's pretty simple to do, but it does require that you actually remember to close your form at the right time, which, when you're juggling a million other things, is a lot easier said than done. If you want a set it and forget it solution, you'll need the automatic option. Here's how to do that. Click on the three-dot menu and head over to the Google Workspace Marketplace. From there, search for an add-on called FormLimiter and follow the prompts to download it. Once you have, you'll be able to access FormLimiter by clicking on the puzzle piece icon at the top of your form. Go ahead and open it up to set your closing parameters. There are two main ways to have your form closed, based on the date or based on the number of submissions. You can select either option from the drop-down menu in FormLimiter. If you're going with the date option, select the day and time you'd like your form to go dark. If you're working with a registration form or a giveaway, you're probably better off picking a maximum number of submissions. Regardless of which option you go with, you can choose to get email notifications when your form is closed and set a custom error message for respondents who try to access your form after the deadline. When you're happy with your settings, click Save and Enable to set them live. And that's it. Your form will close based on the parameters you set. No further work required. For something designed to make your life easier, closing your Google form at a certain time is a lot of work. Doing it manually is easy enough, but let's be real, it's way more convenient to just set a date and move on with your busy life. FormLimiter is great for simple forms, but it comes with its fair share of limitations. You can't create custom success pages to navigate potential leads, and you can't set a custom opening date, which would enable you to create your forms in advance. You also can't close a form based on multiple conditions. For example, on December 31st, or when you reach 1,000 submissions, whichever comes first. If you want more customization options and greater ease of use, Paperform is a great alternative. With Paperform, you can have your form closed at a certain date, when you hit a certain number of submissions, or both in a whichever comes first scenario. There's no need for any extra downloads or extra tools. Just jump into the Configure menu to set all the form closure conditions you might need. You can shut your form down manually by flipping a switch, or set parameters to have it done automatically based on the date, submission number, or both. Easy peasy. You can also create custom success pages, automatically redirect respondents to new forms from your closed ones, and set custom opening dates so you can create all your forms in advance. If you're in the market for a true set it and forget it solution, Paperform is your best bet. Give it a go yourself with our 14-day free trial and see how easy closing forms can be. That's all for this one. Thanks for sticking around. If you liked this video, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more helpful content. Until next time, happy creating.